Good morning, everyone. I'm Brianna Keeler.
And I'm Ivan Watson. It's 6 o'clock. Good morning. This is New Day Saturday. New this morning, a raging wildfire in Yosemite National Park may impact San Francisco 200 miles away. The fire has shut down transmission lines that feed the city.
And that could limit electricity. So at this point, it's really all about the weather. It can be a firefighter's friend. It can be a firefighter's enemy.
And so let's check in now with meteorologist Alexander Steele.
Wild pictures there. Now, also new this morning, San Diego's mayor, Bob Filner, is going out with a bang. He sealed the deal.
He quoted calling this a coup against a democratically elected mayor.
I know.
It's astounding.
It's almost, a lot of people would say that he is delusional, you know? Time will tell. Now, Filner's first accuser, Irene Jackson, who started this, not really started this scandal, because you could say that he did, but she's the one who really brought this to light. She released a statement. She said, well, jurors took less than 7 hours to find Army Major Nadal Hassan guilty of 13 counts of murder in the mass killings of military personnel at Fort Hood, Texas, nearly 4 years ago. Now the jury will deliberate his fate. Well, this morning it appears a federal lawsuit against Southern cooking queen Paula Deen has been resolved. Lawyers signed a deal to dismiss the final part of a discrimination and sexual harassment lawsuit against her, but it's unclear if money will change hands. The celebrity cook said, quote, while this has been a difficult day today, thousands of people are gathering in the nation's capital.
That's right. They are marking the 50th anniversary of a defining moment for U.S. civil rights. The Reverend Martin Luther King Jr.'s March on Washington for jobs and freedom.
Up next, CNN sits down with President Obama for an exclusive one.
Welcome back. In Washington, a very special new edition. It's hard not to smile at this one. A baby panda was born last...
...is defending the NSA after a report this week that the agency broke its own privacy rules thousands and thousands of times.
That's right. And the violations include unauthorized... Chris Cuomo, thanks very much.
Well, the Pentagon has a lot of ideas on how to hit Syria where it hurts, and they're facing a... Staying in Syria as we take you around the world on CNN New Day, UN inspectors are trying to get to the site of that alleged chemical weapons attack, and CNN's Frederick Plytkin is in Damascus. Fred?
Brianna, the evidence is mounting that there was smoke coming out of these neighborhoods. Brianna?
Fred, thank you very much. And now to Mexico City, where thousands of teachers are protesting the government. CNN's Nick Parker is in the Mexican capital. Nick?
This is the scene outside Mexico's Senate with Brianna.
Thanks, Nick. And we're keeping our eye on Italy, where engineers hope to raise the ill-fated Costa Concordia cruise ship from its half-submerged resting place. So let's find out just how they plan to do that. CNN's Aaron McLaughlin is covering that for us. Aaron?
Brianna, it's a massive feat of maritime disaster. Brianna?
Thank you, Aaron. Ivan, over to you.
Thanks.
Time of the hour now. Welcome back, everyone. I'm Brianna Keeler.
And I'm Ivan Watson. Here are five things you need to know for your new day.
Number 1,000.
Now, a quick look at how weather may help or hinder the firefighters. Meteorologist Alexandra...
There just isn't good news for them. And in addition to that terrain that Alexandra just told us about, firefighters are also battling against their own resources.
That's right. Tom Foreman is here to break down the massive price tags of all those fires raging along the West Coast. Good morning, Tom. Much.
35 years behind bars. That certainly was not the only bombshell this week in the case. Eavesdropping on love interest has its own spy label. According to the Wall Street Journal, several officers with the NFA, Well, coming up, we will be talking about coming back. Wait until you hear how can... Good morning, everyone. I'm Brianna Keeler.
And I'm Ivan Watson, and I'm having trouble saying that.
It's so early. It's so early, folks.
It's far too early. In fact, on the East Coast, it's 7 o'clock, and this is New Day Saturday.
Now, first on New Day, wildfire, a wildfire raging in California's Yosemite National Park. It's threatening at this point 4,500 structures this morning.
And the fire is...
Check now for the weather there in Yosemite, how it's going to impact the firefight.
That's right. CNN meteorologist Alexander... It's a day in history. 50 years ago, the Reverend Martin Luther King Jr. led a 250,000 people in the March on Washington.
At the Lincoln Memorial, Dr. King gave his famous I Have a Dream speech, and today marchers will be retracing those steps. So let's go now to CNN's Chris Lawrence.
New this morning, Bob Filner will be San Diego's problem for just one more week.
Caught up in a...
Still to come on New Day. If you think that crushing student loan debt isn't your problem, we... That's President Obama in an exclusive interview with CNN's Chris Cuomo talking about the rippling effect student loan debt can have on the taxpayer.
Yeah, 37 million Americans incentive to make changes happen.
All right. Now, Allison Kosick is live outside New York University, NYU. How does the president plan to fight college costs, Allison?
You know, what the president is doing at
Allison, what are students and their families saying about the plan? Do they like it?
Oh, of course they like it, Brianna, but...
frame for this.
Well, that's the thing. I mean, you know, it would take congressional approval. Who knows?
People aren't going to be getting a relief anytime soon from this crushing debt, student debt.
And not when you're relying on Congress so much, Allison Kosick, unfortunately. At NYU, thank you for your report.
Thanks, Allison.
And still to come on New Day, it was a one-man market push on Wall Street. We will tell you.
And she's going to tell all next.
All right, so check this out. It is caffeine that works like a perfume. It's called sprayable energy. You spray it directly on your body, preferably coffee right there.
Right there, huh?
Quarter cup there.
I tried some earlier. It was,
I just got some in my mouth. Not really tasty.
Yeah, it doesn't smell like coffee.
No?
No.
And I wonder if it's like a placebo effect. I feel awake. I don't know.
I put some on, your advice, I put some on my wrist, two sprays, so that, how much is that? That's a half a cup of coffee?
And I feel as if you are just a little more energetic.
But I was also drinking coffee at the same time.
Okay, so for these, cup of coffee, and the company that's making them now touts them as no calories.
I'm getting used to it.
It's convenient. If you don't like the bitter taste of coffee,
you could take
it's an option.
You could take it camping with you, too.
Exactly.
Right.
All right, so Ivan, you've seen water skis.
Right, and you've seen jet skis, but have you seen jet packs?
That's pretty funny. I always enjoy watching Richard Quest get into a little bit of trouble. Well, you know, Wednesday marks the 50th. And now, welcome back, everyone. I'm Brianna Keeler.
And I'm Ivan Watson, and here are five things you need to know for your new day. Number one,
Wednesday marks the official 50th anniversary of the March on Washington, but thousands are gathering on the National Mall this morning to mark the historic occasion.
Among them, the eldest son of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., a human rights activist in his own right. Martin Luther King III was only a child when his father delivered his famous I Have a Dream speech in 1963.
And he is joining us now.
Welcome back, everyone. We're in the E block, and that means time for entertainment news.
So let's start with a story that has just about exploded online. I mean, we can't stop talking about it.
Nope.
This is the announcement that Ben Affleck will play the Caped Crusader in the next Batman movie. Yes, you heard me right. Christian Bale out, Ben Affleck in. And V103 radio personality Kendra Gilliams joining us now live to discuss. Kendra G.
Okay.
Hey there.
Yay? Nay.
Okay, well, first
let's
of all,
ye.
I'm going to say nay. No hate against Ben Affleck. But come on now, Channing Tatum would be the perfect Batman. I think Ben Affleck, I mean, unless he goes back to those J-Lo days when he had, like, the swag with the green.
Superman. So, Channing Tatum, I'm sorry, he's not old enough to do that.
Yes, he is. He's
but
sexy enough, though.
I have another.
Batman needs to have a swag.
Wait.
Okay. Geek knows Daredevil's from the Marvel universe of comic
cross-pollination,
books.
Cross-pollination, unacceptable.
Exactly. And Batman's from DC Comics, DC Universe. You can't bring these two universes together.
So,
it's just
so
it's
look,
crazy.
Ivan's a purist,
okay.
But I am not. And here's what I will say. Fine jawline, Argo. Only one shirtless scene. I need to see Ben Affleck in more anatomically molded rubber. I'm fine with that.
He does have the
Thank
jawline
you.
For Batman.
You know what? You made it way too complicated. I'm basing it all on sexiness.
See?
Yes.
Me too. Let's see. Okay, we want to get on now to... Cher.
Oh, God.
You know, so Cher, you know that one video, you know the video I'm talking about back in the day?
When she has on,
where
yes.
She's like on the destroyer or whatever it is.
I know what you're talking about.
Now she's 67.
Yes, she is.
She's back with a new video. It's called Woman's World. Here's a look.
No clubs, but you got to think about it. Her fans are still 67. They might be in a home or being a grandma. They won't be able to be on YouTube.
Her, no.
Well, new fans, but she might be kind of old to new fans, to be realistic. But I mean, she got enough money. That body looks good. She got a 40-year-old body.
She looks good, and I kind of like the message with all the different changing bodies and people. And that's
well,
kind of
she can't dance that much. She got to have other people move.
And
for
she
her.
Has, and she has the hair.
Yeah.
All that interesting hair.
Yes.
Okay, so clearly. Kendra G, you are into fashion.
I am.
I mean, I wait every week.
That's a fantastic outfit.
Isn't
well, thank
it?
You so much.
Every week I wait to see what she's wearing, and I get very excited about it. So we're going to ask you what you think of Madonna's latest fashion statement.
Gosh.
Oh, boy.
Mm. Explain what a grill is.
A grill is like a mold.
It's like melting.
Caught inside the
You think she's eating with those on?
I think she may. She may have eaten that day, and the food was just stuck. I don't like the grill.
I don't think she ate because it was at the opening of, like, her fitness studio or something.
Oh, yes.
So.
And then they're uncomfortable. You can't even smile. It's just nasty.
Ivan, I love how you both are, like, very concerned about her orthodonture.
Yes.
You're so cute. Okay. Finally, this is very important. This is like the baby. Remember, we were all waiting for Suri Cruz back in the day. Okay, well, finally, we get to see
the finale of Kris Jenner, which I thought was so cute because I wasn't sure if they would get married one day, but he is in awe of this family. And the baby is
a beautiful baby.
Beautiful.
Right, right.
Yeah.
Yes. Well, Kendra G from V103, thanks for catching me up to date on some of this stuff. And it's a pleasure meeting you.
Thank you. And shout out to my stylist, Harrison, who does all my outfits.
And fantastic
bow
there.
I think he will send him over to Madonna.
Yes, right. No grills.
No grills. Kendra, thank you so much.
Thank you.
And still to come here on New Day, they said, according to Chinese tradition, we're not going to know what this thing is named because you wait 100 days.
Wait 100 days for
it's
that.
Be
Don't
a while.
Call it stick of butter, please.
No, don't.
Renee Marsh, she's outside National Zoo this morning with all the details on the new baby panda. Renee, in Washington, thanks. Stick with us. We'll be right back.
All right, installing it as we speak, because if you are single and looking to mingle, well, there's an app for that. But move aside, guys. It is for ladies only.
Yeah, I guess so, because this new app is called Lulu, and it's causing quite a stir, and it's giving women a public venue to dish the dirt on their exes and potential love interests. I'm not sure I want to know what's in this. CNN's Lori Segal explains. Good morning, Lori.
All right, Lori, thanks so much. What do you think, Ivan? Ivan hates it.
I'm frightened. Well, what would happen if we came up with an app like this for women?
There was a website like this called Hot or Not. So look, we've been there, my friend.
Okay. All
this has been done to us. So you know what? Payback.
And some of those hashtags may apply to me, not being able to build IKEA furniture.
No. Do you wear Crocs?
No.
Phew. Well, look, Ivan has that going for him, so I think you'd probably get like a 9 or something. Well, thank you so much for starting your morning with us.
The next hour of your new day starts right now.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Brianna Keeler.
And I'm Ivan Watson. It's 8 o'clock. This is New Day Saturday.
Now, just into CNN, the president is meeting with his security team this morning to discuss the crisis in Syria. Mr. Obama is weighing his options.
This morning, that ferocious wildfire raging in California's Yosemite National Park is threatening 4,500 structures.
And this thing is moving so fast that it doubled in size in just a day. Its impact may even be felt 200 miles away in San Francisco.
So we'll explain that in a moment. First to CNN's Nick Valencia. So let's talk hail and fire with CNN meteorologist Alexander Steele. Alexander, this morning, San Diego Mayor Bob Filner will be out of a job beginning next Friday, but not out of the spotlight. This week marks a watershed moment for civil rights.
Thousands are gathering in the nation's capital to remember, to reflect, and also to call to action on August 28th night.
Coming out of college buried under student loan debt, Allison Kosick is in New York following that for us.
Up the heroic acts of Antoinette Tuff. So kids are not the only ones who say the darndest things. Politicians do as well.
The difference is you would think politicians would know better. Meet Congresswoman Anna Maria.
What to say about that? Okay, so Ortiz said that comment was taken out of context.
How do you do that?
Unclear. She tried to clarify her own position, saying that she meant that in a respectful manner.
Again, I don't know quite how to take that in or out of context.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so moving on. Next up, Colorado State Senator Vicky Marble. She was trying...
Maybe she would have been okay if she just stopped there, but of course, she didn't. All right. Well, but not everyone loved that comment, as you can imagine. Critics slammed her, and Marble actually released a statement saying the comment wasn't meant to be disparaging to any community. Though it was, obviously.
Sometimes it's just better to keep your mouth shut.
Yep. Zip it.
Okay. So we'll stick with politics right after the break and keep our mouths shut.
Christine Romans has a preview of Your Money coming up in about an hour from now. Good morning, Christine. To meet the modern-day version of Mr. Belushi's character. This guy's no Bluto, though.
Nope.
It's okay. Nicholas is joining us now. And I take it, Nick, this was not your first time on stage?
That's true. That's true. Yeah.
You've done this before?
Yes. Not quite to this extent, but yeah.
And where did this inspiration from the speech come from?
Sure, it was actually formed a similar speech in college. It was actually on science fiction literature, though, and he did the whole, like, epic, yeah, sure, and so I did, and everybody loved it.
Can I ask, what did the freshman class think of it? What did their faces look like?
You know, so we spoke to Andy Stone, your speech coach, yesterday. Uh-huh. He said he was very proud of you. Have you spoken to him since the speech went viral?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. He's a really cool guy, like a really, really cool guy. I'm a huge, huge fan of his.
Okay.
So gracious towards me is he knows that he's an amazing person in my mind.
You
so.
Perhaps succeeded.
She's enjoying this.
She wasn't surprised.
No, she was very, very surprised that this thing exploded like it did, as was everyone.
That you were the one giving this speech. And were the professors cool with you? I sort of looked behind you to see how they would react to you. They were sort of unsure at first, and then they got into it.
Yeah, kind of that. And they really liked that, so I got to speak.
And you're breaking stereotype, because you're a mechanical engineer. I went to school with some of those, and, uh-huh, and they're not typically...
Keeping it real.
Well.
All right. Thank you, I think. Yeah.
No, I mean, it was amazing.
And before we do go, Nick... Give us a little line tailored to CNN, please.
Okay. Well, if you want facts...
Nick Selby, thank you so much for coming by. We love that.
Thank you.
You know, have you ever felt that you would just...
Welcome back. They're just teenagers, but already they've survived war, genocide, and even the loss of their families. Now, some of these girls are beginning a new life in Chicago with a whole new set of problems.
But this week, CNN Hero has made it her mission to help them. Meet Blair Bretschneider. See you right back here at the top of the hour, but up next, 29-year-old Mark Zuckerberg's plans to connect the entire planet.
Your money starts right now.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Brianna Keeler.
And I'm Ivan Watson. It's 10 o'clock on the East Coast, 7 on the West, and you're in the CNN newsroom.
Hour with history being made again today in the nation's capital.
That's right. Marchers are retracing the landmark 1963 March on Washington. It was 50 years ago Wednesday that the Reverend Martin Luther King Jr. called for an end to hatred and bigotry in his I Have a Dream speech.
And CNN's Chris Lawrence is on the National Mall. King's eldest son is at that rally today. A short time ago, Martin Luther King III told us what he hopes this march will achieve.
That's Martin Luther King III talking about today's march and what it means. Now, I want to bring in CNN Crossfire host Van Jones in Los Angeles, and also joining us from years and start to move overseas, I think. We have gotten our own Fred Plaitkin. He's on the phone with us from Syria right now.
Yeah, Syria, and hopefully... And so first off, new this morning, President Obama has his national security team. They are there at the White House to weigh options on Syria. And one of the things we'll talk to Fred about is the graphic images out of Syria that appear to show the results of a chemical attack. Let's take a look. These are CNN's Fred Plaitkin kind of comes in here. He's joining us on the phone.
And Fred, you've been in Syria a couple days now trying to learn more about whether or not these chemical weapons were used there. What are you seeing today there in Syria? The deadliest case of chemical weapons used, certainly in that region, since Saddam Hussein gassed Iraqi Kurds in northern Iraq in the late 80s, killing roughly 5,000 people.
And certainly if it is proven that it is the Syrian government that is the perpetrator of this, as Syrian rebels allege, that is something that the White House has made clear is very much a red line for them. They said that in the past, but it seems like this would be a much clearer red line than what we've seen happen in the past.
Absolutely. Now, moving on, a monster wildfire is raging out of control near Yosemite National Park in California.
Flames are threatening.
Now, after a summer of sensational allegations, San Diego's mayor finally quits. Welcome back. Bob Filner is vacating the mayor's office at San Diego City Hall. but not without a parting shot.
That's right. His resignation comes after a summer filled with allegations of sexual harassment. 18 women now have accused Filner of kissing, groping, and other lewd behavior. Now, the mayor went out by proclaiming his innocence and zinging the media.
Now, let's bring in Trent Siebert. He's an investigative reporter for the San Diego Union-Tribune. Trent, could you tell us anything about the details of the city's deal with the soon-to-be former mayor?
Absolutely. There are three
matching their heads this. They They saw Filner a few weeks ago. He seemed very apologetic, said he was going into therapy. Since then, we've seen many, many more women come out. And now, while he says he apologizes to them, he also says he didn't sexually harass any of them. I mean, how do you kind of, can you even explain this? It's puzzling.
You can't. It is puzzling. It's bizarre. It's been bizarre from the beginning with allegation after allegation. I think there's a bit of a sigh of relief collectively here in San Diego because he said he would resign.
And Trent, CNN's reporting that the Attorney General of the state of California is launching a criminal investigation into the former mayor. What potential crimes would they be investigating?
Well, you've hit it. This is just one, you know, for folks in the region. So that if there are allegations of harassment,
hearing a lot more about Filner even after he steps.
You know, many allergy sufferers don't have much choice but to carry an EpiPen, but two men who know what that's like have created a new... Welcome back, everyone. I'm Brianna Keeler.
And I'm Ivan Watson, and I'm having a trouble saying my own
We've
name.
We've had a long morning.
We've had a long morning, that's right.
Serious story, though, we want to talk about now. Mm-hmm. Syria, this is the big story today. Syria is claiming that rebels are using chemical weapons against... Well, EpiPens can prevent life-threatening reactions for allergy sufferers, but twins Evan and Eric Edwards found them pretty cumbersome, too cumbersome, in fact, to carry around, especially as teenagers. And their alternative version is this week's Human Factor.
Impressive brothers there. Well, their faces may be older, but their voices have lost none of their passion.
A California community is expected to remember the mother and brother of Hannah Anderson later today during a public memorial service.
The bodies of Christina and Ethan were found in the burned to learn whether she'll live or die. Stepping all over you here.
You're about to learn a few secrets that didn't come out at Jodi Arias' murder trial. We're going to be talking live with Jane Velez Mitchell about...
Exposed... The Secret Life of Jodi Arias.
Thanks for having me.
Hey,
Brianna.
Thanks for joining.
Thank you.
So what are some of the secrets that we could get from your new book?
Well, look, Jodi Arias had another boyfriend in much the same way she terrorized Travis Alexander many years earlier. So this shows a pattern. The jury never heard about that. She also been standing behind the same counter. So she had serious, serious dysfunction before she met Travis Alexander, the victim.
And that's something I think you kind of, even you see just in the cover of your book here, you see kind of the two different faces of Jodi mm-hmm. Arias. And yeah. That's certainly something that came out there in the trial. Shot him in the head. I mean, do you sort of delve into how someone gets to that point of moral depravity?
Absolutely. That's the whole point of the book. Look, I was there. Now, sex was all over this case, obviously. Now, she tried to present herself as behaving inappropriately and very aggressive sexually. And Travis had told his best friend that she was, and this is a direct quote, a nymphomaniac. The way to merge with somebody else is through sex. So I believe, and I make a compelling case, that the reason she waited so long before...
Wow. Now, you said, Stephanie, that one of the goals of your book here was to try to clear Travis Alexander's name. What do you mean by that?
Using that cell phone sex tape that's filled with some very raunchy language to blackmail him. And that's a complicated case, but I make it in the book.
You did kind of walk away with not a very, even though yeah. you sort of felt like he was the victim, you walked away with not mm-hmm. maybe a great feeling.
But he was a good guy. He was a good guy, and a lot of people loved him, and he was trying to make this world a better place.
I dedicated. Loved animals, and this is the book, Exposed, The Secret Life of Joe.
Welcome back, everyone. In Washington, there's a very special new addition, a baby panda born last night at the National.
To the tale of Marcus. He is a 4-year-old yellow lab, once in training with the Canadian National Institute for the Blind. Now, officially, Marcus is called the hotel's director of pet relations.
Okay.
He's got a title. It's on his business card, I think.
And he clearly has the social skills for that.
Yes.
Very weighty and important job. Now, moving on. Every year...
Do it for us today. Thanks so much for watching. We're going to turn it over to our colleague, Frederica Whitfield. Hey, Fred.
Hey, good to see you both. Thanks so much.